Good afternoon, guys. I'm glad you're all here. Some of you have been asking about the earthquakes that have been occurring there in the Gulf of California. The most recent that USGS is reporting is a 4.6. For some reason, USGS does not report all the earthquakes that occur down there. At least some of them. La Palma, they don't report any of the earthquakes that are occurring in La Palma. You can see we got a cluster here, and we'll go to the 4.6 that USGS did report right there. Many of these are from the Mexican seismology station, whatever you want to call it, SSN. You'll see down here at the mouth, we have three listed. We have a 4.1 that was yesterday. Another 4.0 that was yesterday. And today a 4.0. Now a week ago, USGS has a 5.0 listed down here at the mouth of the Gulf of California, but nothing more recent, which is these three right here, a 4.1 and two 4.0s. So let me bring it out. You can see it's down here by the mouth of the Gulf of California. All these earthquakes here are from within the last 2 days. And USGS has six listed here. There's a couple that are off the map. And then only two down here. Like I said, that one is from the 13th. And this other one is from the 16th. So going back to Google Earth, I posted what the Mexican government had for the last 2 days. And there's been a cluster of them up over here. And the blue line that I drew out is the Gulf of California Rift System. The western side, what we call Baja California, is slowly being pulled, going north. This whole center, this rift system, is an area of spreading. Baja California area is moving west at about 2 inches a year. And then we got the movement also 2 inches a year going north. I've talked a lot about different rift systems we got here in the United States. You know, we got the New Madrid rift system. That's a failed rift system. And here we have the Gulf of California rift system. This rift system is the northernmost extension of the East Pacific Rise. Now this rift system extends some 800 miles from the mouth of the Gulf of California to the southern terminus of the San Andreas Fault at the Salton Sink, which would be the Salton Sea. Let's go up here. So this rift system extends all the way up here to this location right here. A few of these earthquakes looks like they're caused by the dragging of the Baja California area being drugged by the Pacific Plate going north. This cluster of earthquakes looks like it's probably being caused by the spreading of this rift system. And there's a fault line. You can see it right there. Now this rift system is part of the East Pacific Rise, which actually extends out, and it's slowly moving north also, and it's part of the Riviera Plate, which they believed at one time was subducting underneath the North American Plate. Recent studies that was submitted this year shows that the Riviera Plate is no longer subducting under the North American Plate, but is being dragged along too with that Pacific Plate going north. The Riviera Plate and the Cocos Plate were all at one time one plate, which is down here. And then, geologic collisions occurred big time, which caused a reshuffling of plate tectonic boundaries, which started to form these mini microplates. Right in the middle between the Riviera Plate and the Cocos Plate, south of it, is the Jalisco Plate. or the Jalisco block, as they call it. The largest earthquake that they ever had in Mexico was in that location in 1932. And they have a large destructive earthquake on average about every 77 years. So they're past due for a large earthquake again. So here at the mouth of California, it changes from spreading to a transform fault. This is where we have different boundaries of the plates. And this is where the Riviera Plate is also now being dragged, going north with the Pacific Plate. But I wanted to look at these earthquakes that were right at the junction. There was a magnitude 4.2 that was in March of this year. And there was also another 4.2 that was February of this year. The Mexican site has three earthquakes listed for that area. A 4.1, which was yesterday. Today, a 4.0. And another 4.0 that was on the 17th, yesterday. If I change it to 3 days, let's see, that's the 18th, that's the 17th. The 16th, there was a 4.1. And a 4.5 on the 16th. This site only allows me to go back 3 days. Then if we go up here to this location where the cluster of earthquakes have been happening. Let's check them out here. Okay, there was a 3.7 on the 16th. That's the 17th. 18th. 17th, 17th, another 17th, 18th, what do we got down here? 18th, yeah, we get a whole bunch more. It looks like a total of 27 within the last 3 days. And I've talked about rift systems becoming more active of late, and that's definitely an indication, which is going to put pressure out here, opening up, making the division between Baja California and Mexico even wider. How this might affect the San Andreas Fault, I don't know. They really don't have a lot of data about this. The geology of this region is really complex. This rift system is bringing up magma. And the waters down there are over 200 degrees Celsius. We got San Diego and Santa Barbara being pushed up towards the San Francisco Bay Area. More likely, this is going to encourage the movement of the Baja area plate. And you could probably see earthquakes maybe down by San Diego and up in the Salton Sea as it tries to push further northward. In the last day, there's been 22 earthquakes within this location. You can see several here. A 1.4 and a 2.0. The most recent is this one right here, Anza, California, a 1.5. I believe that's the largest. That was today, a magnitude 3.0. Yeah, I'll bring this over so you can see what I'm looking at. And as you know, this area here, Southern California, that area is about 350 years overdue for a large earthquake. And the Gulf of California Rift joins up with the San Andreas Fault. You'll see here, they only have 7 earthquakes listed for the last week for this location of the Gulf of California Rift. Where right here in just this location, there's over 27 earthquakes within the last 3 days alone. Like I said, some of these earthquakes are from spreading. Some of them are from the movement. The separation of Baja California slowly being pushed northward. But that's a lot of earthquakes that USGS is not reporting within the last 3 days alone. So if you have any thoughts or comments or questions, please put it down below. I'll try and answer it the best I can. Thank you very much for watching. Thank you very much for your support. And I hope everyone has a very Merry Christmas. God bless y'all. Bye.